course of the crime scene. The death toll has reached over 1,000 and residents are being encouraged to stay home. Governor Richards has mobilized the National Guard in order to contain the situation. Now, to Karen with your local weather.
Save it, Karen. We all know it's going to be partly cloudy with a chance of hailing. Damn realtor said he cleared everything out. Can't trust anyone. But you can trust your government. The voice of the people. Right. Love for humanity. That's trash. King Kong and the Gray Man. This can be fun. King Kong, y'all on the radio? King Kong, this is Gray Man. Gray Man for King Kong, do you copy? Headhunter, do you copy? This is Gray Man. Gray Man for Headhunter, do you copy?
Yeah, I copy.
What's happening?
The world's gone insane again. But they only told us what they wanted us to know. You got the doors barred and your guns loaded?
Yeah.
Well, how's the new bug out?
It's good. How did you know about it?
We talked last week. Did you do your research?
Yep.
Did you do your research?
All right, no.
Damn it, man. I told you, you gotta research a house before you buy it. What if some pervert lived there? You want the cops to be hammering on your door thinking that some Lester the molester's inside?
Yeah, well, it was a deal. It's exactly what I needed, and it's already paying off, so.
Yeah, what if some prior owner was cooking meth? Did you toss everything? You got the house sealed?
Yeah.
See, that's what I'm talking about. You get your house all sealed up and then wham! You get hit by leftover meth fumes and you're dead in a couple of hours. Hell, no one listens to me. You watch the news?
The government owns the media. Why the hell would I do that?
It always starts out as some lame virus that no one ever heard of. And then the military's called in because there's rumors of rioting. Then, once the military shows up, they start wanting to search your house to see if you got any of that virus. But that's really not what they're looking for. They're looking for your guns. You got a God-given constitutional right to have every damn gun that's made. Don't matter if it can take out a squirrel or an armored tank. You got the right as a United States of American citizen to defend yourself, to protect what's yours.
Headhunter, do you think it's aliens?
Aliens? No, it ain't aliens unless you count the Japanese as aliens. I heard from a buddy who knows this guy whose nephew works at this diner over in on the Pacific where a bunch of LAPD detectives stopped in, and they're talking about how they heard from Hoover's boys that some Japanese ships had been spotted by the coast.
Japanese?
Yeah, but I don't believe it. My guess would be the Russians. They've always been itching for a chance to waltz in and take over. You got your plywood up?
Yep. Peephole and all. How the hell does he know all this?
Good, good. Now, you put the plywood on the inside?
Would you prefer I put it on the outside?
Hell no! Every civilian would be thinking that you're some kind of a survivalist if you put it on the outside. Which you are. They'll be pounding on your door wanting you to show a little mercy, a little pity on your fellow man by giving them some free food. If you ain't prepared, to hell with them.
I'm not some kind of damn charity. Have you heard from King Kong?
You know your voice, it don't sound right. Your voice... Are you Gray Man? Answer me.
Yes, I'm Gray Man. I just moved into this place. Bug out, it's dusty. Okay, it's my sinuses.
Yeah, you're a Gray Man, all right. Only Gray Man would complain about their sinuses.
So, about King Kong, have you heard from him?
Yeah, he's dead.
Dead? As in dead, dead?
Dead. The big stupid monkey was trying to secure his damn vehicles, which were parked outside. I told him, keep your vehicles inside.
Huh. So what happened?
Some jackass decided he wanted King Kong's car. So he shoved a gun in his face. But King Kong tried to put up a fight rather than putting a bullet in the scum's head. The scum put a bullet in King Kong's head and took his car. Just left him there, dying in the street. Hell, people talk about some deadly virus. I'll tell you about a virus. It's called scum, the kind that walks around on 2 feet. Now, what the government needs to do is to kill that virus off. I gotta go. Someone's knocking on the door. Maybe I'll get to use my new .223 fully automatic rifle. Talk to you later. Headhunter is off the air.
Gray Man's off the air. This could be fun. Stay anonymous. Unlike our friends over at the Not So Anonymous. Entertaining.
I got water, food. The windows are covered, the doors are blocked. Now if I could just keep from killing myself, I'll be all right.
Hello? Police? Is anyone home? Hello? We're checking the neighborhood. We need for you to open the door.
No one's here. Look at the windows. They're boarded up.
Yeah.
But from the inside. Come on, open the door.
We're not here for you. We need to make sure that you're okay. There's been...
Come on, we got other houses to check. Someone's inside, they're on their own. They had their chance.
Yo, Gray Man. Clown. You on the air? I got some info for you. Come on, man. Are you on the air? Are you there?
Yeah, I copy. Headhunter, do you copy?
Yeah, you're lucky. I was just about ready to sign off.
You said something about info. What information?
Yeah, some good info. And this ain't for dissemination. It's just between you and me. You hear me?
Yeah, a copy. Headhunter! Do you copy, Headhunter?
Look, you tell anyone and I'll hunt you down, boy. It ain't some damn virus and it ain't any of your damn Jap relatives. It's aliens.
What?
It's damn aliens.
Where? Where were they?
Where are they from? Hell, how the hell do I know? And what difference does it make? You think some alien from Mars is gonna come down here and hang out with you? They won't.
So what do we do? Headhunter, come in. Headhunter!
Join our White House correspondent, Carol Manning, who is waiting for the president to address the country concerning recent events. We understand that the president will be joined by the CDC director.
Yes, it is anticipated that the CDC director will present the latest statistics as well as provide a status of where they are in containing the virus.
Gray Man, did you crash and burn? Gray Man, you sickle, are you on the air?
I searched the house.
Well, how nice. And what did you find?
Some DVDs.
I told you to search the house before you bought it, and especially before you moved in.
Why would anyone hide DVDs in a floor vent?
Because it's a good hiding place. At the DVDs. If someone hid it, then they didn't want anyone to see it, and it has to be really bad. I'm telling you, don't look at the DVDs. Just gather it all up, put it in a bag, and oh, put some gloves on first, and wipe all the items down, then put it all in a bag. And when they let us leave our houses, then...
Who, the aliens?
Aliens? What the heck is wrong with you? What are you talking about?
You said it wasn't a virus, you said it wasn't the Japanese, and you said it was aliens.
You're one dumb moron. I was joking. It's a virus. I just talked to Norman. He works at the power company. He said he was out repairing a transformer. And the guy on the crew was saying that he had been at the hospital, you know, on account of his wife is having a baby. Sees this world just doesn't need any more kids. Anyway, the government should have...
Can we stay on the virus, please?
You're one stupid, angry dude, Nancy, son of a bitch. So Norman says that the hospital has set up a containment ward, and the virus, it's like this flesh-eating disease, only worse. It's not aliens, it's a virus. Now, how you doing, Gray Man? Being locked up inside, you know, it can make you go crazy.
I'm fine. Just talking to some nutcase on a radio.
I remember my first vacation in the state pen.
It's a surprise. It's been locked up.
I didn't know what stir crazy was until I caught it. You're locked in that little cell with some big bubba. The walls start to move, you get all restless, you're already trapped, but you feel like there's no escape and your mind starts to play tricks on you. Start to see things that ain't there, that ain't real. Need to keep your mind occupied. I like to do crossword puzzles. It makes you think. Damn, MRE must have been bad. I gotta go. Headhunter is off the air.
Hey, Headhunter. I'm about to keep my mind occupied.
My name isn't important. My message is. There are several government conspiracies which are true. 8 to be exact. 8 that have been proven to be true. Number 1. The government controls the media.
Widespread looting has been reported.
The media reports what?
And a National Guard spokesperson is reporting that deadly confrontations are prevalent.
The government wants you to peer.
was just off balance. I fell over.
It wasn't my fault. I didn't mean to do it. They made me do it. Between 1948 and 1972, over 400 journalists carried out secret assignments for the CIA. You think the media can be trusted?
I'm armed! Just to take the edge off.
Yo, Gray Man, pull your pants up and talk to me. Come on, talk to me.
Come here.
What the hell were you doing?
I'm making rounds.
Good, good. Everything okay? No signs of entry?
No, but...
You're hearing things, right?
How the hell do you know?
Happens all the time, but it ain't nothing. All houses creak and moan. It's a natural thing. You looked at the DVDs, didn't you? You know what they say, curiosity killed the cat. Was it some young chick? That's the only thing worth putting on DVDs.
It wasn't porn, it was some guy talking about government conspiracies.
No shit?
No shit. So the media's controlled by the government.
Yeah, and what else?
That there's like 8 conspiracies that are actually true.
Does it show his face? Does he say his name?
No, he's just sitting in a chair with his back to the camera.
My man, I think he just found the Holy Grail.
The Holy Grail of what?
Well, there's like this guy. Some say he was in the CIA and that's how he knows so much. Well, he's like a legend. What I wouldn't give to see those DVDs. Damn, you gotta watch the rest of them. See if the, you know, if they detail anything about the 8 conspiracies. This could be the motherlode. We could copy them and headhunters off the air.
Yeah. I'll just sit here and watch the rest of the DVDs.
Like a Hollywood movie director, the government is staging terrorist attacks on America.
Please!
A country that is afraid. I know you. I know what you are. You can't hurt me.
Please, please, don't do this. Let me go. I won't tell anyone.
You don't scare me!
Please!
Headhunter. This is Gray Man, are you there? Headhunter. Are you there? Do you copy?
Yeah. You're like one of my ex-girlfriends with a huge emphasis on ex. Damn, don't you have anything else to do? I was just getting ready to fix me a bowl of doomsday stew, and what makes mine world famous is putting two candles.
Ghosts! Do you believe in ghosts? Headhunter. Do you copy? Headhunter, I think I'm losing it, man. Headhunter!
Yeah. If you want free advice, maybe you need to listen when I'm talking and quit stepping on me when I've got my button pushed down. This is Radio Etiquette 101. You let the other guy talk, and when he stops, then you press your little button so you can talk. I was talking. Are you going to listen to me, or maybe you want to reach out to one of your little college-educated, panty-wearing sissy girls? Well, are you going to speak up like a man? Well?
I'm listening.
Yeah, I figured you'd still be there. Where the hell else are you going to go? Yeah, I believe in ghosts. That's why I told you that you should have done a little internet recon before you bought your little redneck castle. So what happened?
The films. At first they were conspiracies, and then all of a sudden there's a woman taped to a chair. And the man is cutting with knives and there's blood dripping down her body, down the chair and onto the floor, and there's a big stain. Now, when I moved into this house, there was no stain. But just now, in the living room, there was a stain in the same exact part of the house as in the video. But then when I look again, it's not there. There's no stain. I think I'm seeing things.
Surprise, you watch a snuff film, then you begin imagining things.
And there's a shadow, like there's someone in the house with me. But whenever I search the house, there's no one there. Like it's a ghost.
Okay, listen to me. Ghosts be the same as live people. You just gotta show them who is in charge. You see some shadow, you just walk up to it and say, "This is my house, now go get me a beer." Do you have internet service?
No.
What's your address?
For what?
Give me your address, unless you want to find out the history of all your ghosts on your own.
It's 282 South Elm Avenue.
Got it. Now I need to go into the other room to run the address. Do another sweep of the house, see if you see anything suspicious. Headhunter is off the air.
Thank you.
Social Sarah. This is Gray Man. Do you copy? Gray Man to Social Sarah. Are you on the air?
Well, hello, handsome. What a gorgeous night. Especially since the Germans lost.
But the Germans lose.
Hussars have occupied Tunis.
I'm in America. Where are you?
You're such a tease, Gray Man. Of course, I know you're in America, and you know that I'm in London.
London? Well, here in America, Sarah, our government has imposed a curfew on the American people, requiring them to stay inside in order to avoid contracting a virus. Is this the same over in London?
Oh, well, that's terrible, but no, I hadn't heard. Is it a part of the war?
I'm sure it's associated with the war on terrorism, yeah.
You know, my grandmama tells me that these things are only going to get worse, but she's been dead for 10 years, so I'm not sure whether I can trust her opinion.
So, Sarah, it sounds like you believe in ghosts.
Oh, yes, of course I believe in ghosts. My favorite story about ghosts is actually about the Borley Rectory, which was built in 1862 by Reverend Bull.
Right.
Reverend Bull built the house on the very site of an earlier rectory, which had been completely destroyed by a fire in 1841. The good Reverend needed to enlarge the house in order to accommodate his 14 children. Can you imagine 14 children?
So the Reverend, did he see ghosts? What did he see?
Oh, I'm sorry. I sometimes get carried away. After the house was built, several visitors would often comment about hearing footsteps, but whenever they would investigate, they would discover no one. Then there was the appearance of a ghost. Several members of Reverend Bull's family reported seeing an apparition, which they described as resembling a nun. Whenever the apparition was approached and talked to, the apparition would simply vanish. And then there was the appearance of a horse-drawn carriage driven by a headless horseman.
So they saw something that looked like a ghost and they heard noises?
Yes. This is the norm with ghosts. They rarely shake chains and howl. Oh, I almost forgot. And then there were the bells. When Reverend Bull built his house, he installed, as was the custom, service bells throughout the house, which family members could pull a cord, ring a bell, and summon a servant. After the house went through several owners and the bells had been removed, people would still occasionally hear the service bells being rung. So many people have been misled to believe the ghost of Island, when in reality...
Thank you.
Or was it?
Yo, Gray Man. You on the air? I got some more info for you. Come on, you piece of shit. I haven't got all night.
Piece of shit is here, prick.
You killed me. You killed me, Gray Man. So here's the 411. You bought a haunted house, and not just any old haunted house, but a haunted house of a serial killer. Now, make that two serial killers. So they think.
Great.
Seems that Morgan Thomas. You ever hear of him? Yeah, it don't matter. Morgan Thomas killed over 20 women. At least they found 20 bodies under the house. Spent days digging up bodies. After they found the bodies, they filled the crawl space with cement. Guess they didn't want anyone else burying bodies under your house. Anyway, Morgan was convinced that all the women were involved in some government conspiracy. My ex, damn it, I always wondered why she wanted me to sign papers and... Yeah.
You're one dumb redneck.
Anyway, they nailed Morgan back in... Actually, when the cops found Morgan, he had put a bullet in his head. And then a few years later, the house was bought by some reverend.
Reverend?
Yeah. A bunch of girls went missing, and when the cops kicked in the door, they found the reverend swinging from a rope. Oh, and they found the girls locked in a room. The old bastards had been... The house went through a bunch of other owners, with all of them offing themselves.
Yeah, real strange.
Don't you think? Nope. Anyway, like I told you, you gotta do your due diligence and research before you buy. Well, the good thing is that after every moron offed themselves, the cops dug up under the crawl space just to make sure there weren't more bodies buried. Hell, your house has been inspected more times than people have turned up dead inside the house. Say, if you were going to off yourself, how would you do it? Oh, yeah. I get it. I get it, Gray Man. You'd like to slit your belly open like you're gutting a pig. Now, is that the way you do it? You moron. You buy a house you know nothing about. Then when you start seeing ghosts, you start crying like a little girl. You're nothing but a little sissy.
Enough!
Tell me what you know. I didn't want to. You made me. You're studying me like I'm some kind of freak. I didn't want to.
Man, are you on the air? social, Sarah. She said, you think your house is haunted. Gray man.
I'm here.
Oh, thank God. I was getting so worried. My boy, are you okay? You know, it's terrible, just terrible what they did to you. After all those years of faithful service, just to fire you for no good reason. Gray man, are you still there?
Yeah. What did Social Sarah say?
Social Sarah? Yes. She was also worried about you. Gray man, be honest with me. Have you been drinking?
No more than usual. There's something in this house that isn't human.
The mind is a very complex, and sometimes it creates an alter reality. Something that we either want to see something that could be in our future, or something from our past that we don't want to see.
We just have all the answers, don't you, Papa Bear? You got everything figured out. Who are you?
Sorry, if an evil person, per some convoluted definition espoused by society, was to die, then I can understand their reluctance in leaving this world for hell. But then, what is hell? Living in a world that condemns you for longings which are as timeless as the human existence. And Gray Man, are you still there? Sorry, I tend to ramble.
I can help you.
I will talk to you later.
Please. I promise not to
tell. There's no such thing as a ghost.
Gray Man, are you on the air? It's Social Sarah. I conducted a little research on ghosts for you. If you're there.
Yeah, I'm here.
Oh, good.
Look, I'm seeing all kinds of things. There's these girls that are just, they're skipping around them in circles, and then I hear things in the room, and when I look in the closet, there's girls in there.
Shh, it's okay. Calm down. Listen, I spoke to the headhunter, and he told me what he learned about your house. You poor thing. Such violence. It's no wonder you're seeing things.
So how do I make it stop?
The majority of ghosts remain at the place of their deaths, like your house, because they become trapped between the worlds of the living and the dead.
You sound like my grandmother.
And you sound like a skeptic.
I guess seeing is believing, and I've seen all kinds of shit tonight.
Listen, ghosts become trapped between the two worlds due to some unresolved conflict. I would imagine that in the case of the serial killer, like Morgan Thomas, that the horrific manner in which he killed his victims has caused them and him to remain inside the house. And in the case of the Reverend, who misbehaved, maybe you see visions of him because he killed himself.
But I also see the girls.
Headhunter didn't mention anything about the Reverend killing any of the girls, but there is a possibility that he did kill some of the girls, which would explain.
That would explain. That's why I'm seeing.
They're ghosts.
Listen, I can't get out of the house. How do I get rid of the ghosts?
You need to resolve whatever issues keeps them from leaving your house.
Issues? What issues? Morgan Thomas blew his head off. It sounds like that issue's been resolved. The Reverend hung himself. Issue also resolved.
Perhaps the ghosts of the victims have remained because their bodies are still inside the house?
No. No, Headhunter said that every time that there was an incident in the past, the police would come in and they would remove the bodies. Now, when I bought the house, I had it inspected. There's no bodies.
Okay, well, maybe there's an item or something that belonged to the victims which they treasured, like a toy or...
Toys? I found toys when I was cleaning up.
Yes, okay, so the toys, they could be the items which are keeping the ghosts inside the house.
So I just get rid of the toys?
Yes, but removing the toys might work, but...
But then what about the killers?
You would want to take the toys to a peaceful place where the ghosts would feel inclined to follow. Perhaps after they follow the toy to a happier place, then they would simply float up to heaven.
Float to heaven?
If the victims left your house, then there would be no reason for the ghost of the killers to remain.
I like the sound of that.
Gray Man? Are you there?
But I can't leave the house.
Oh. You can't get rid of the ghost if you can't leave your house. Not again. Social Sarah's off the air.
Come on, where are the batteries? You wanna play games? Come on, let's play. You got to the count of 10 to get out of my house.
No.
Get out! 1, 2, 3.
Please.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10!
No. I know nothing.
You know nothing? You gave them my location. Did you tell them my plan?
Tell me what you know.
Why did you kill me?
Just what I need.
But let me assure you, I'm here for you. And I'm praying that you make it through this difficult time.
Difficult time, huh, Papa Bear? Difficult time. What are you talking about? Hey, Papa Bear, do me a favor and why don't you tell me what I did, just as a reminder, because I think I'm in denial.
Oh, yes, denial, yes. Sometimes our minds convince ourselves that we're good, decent people in order to prevent us from, well, realizing that we're evil. Gray Man, remember you asked me to help you. And I also think it would do you good to hear what you did, so your wounds can heal. Okay? You kidnapped and tortured a young woman. I watched it on the news. It was horrific. Horrific. But I'm sure it was because of your drinking. Understand, you have to accept that just because you do one wrong thing doesn't make you a bad person.
I'm only gonna ask you once, Papa Bear. And don't you screw with me. But Morgan was involved, and the Reverend was involved. Are you telling me that there was one more person?
Yes, and it was you. I know it's been difficult, but if you don't accept it, and we wouldn't want that. You didn't kill that poor girl. Horrible, staking her out on the floor, nailing her hands and feet to the floor. You've done your time. But sometimes confession is good for the soul. I'm here. If you want to confess.
Yeah, I'm a little preoccupied at the moment, thanks. Yeah, I'm here.
Were you able to get rid of the items?
No. Headhunter said something about the Reverend killing little girls, and then I, or some guy tortured a woman.
Oh my, so much blood. That's quite the house you've bought. How are you holding up?
Oh, you know, nothing a little bit of whiskey can't fix.
Grayman, are you on the air? Grayman.
What?
Please promise me that you won't start drinking again.
I'm not gonna start drinking again. I'm just gonna continue.
I want you to know that we're friends.
What do you mean, friends?
I saw it in the newspaper, and I have to go help roll bandages, but I'll be back later. Social Sarah's off the air.
Down around your ankles again? Grayman, I know you're home. Or are you off to yourself? Did I ever tell you that the Reverend didn't just molest little girls, but he also killed some of them? Yeah, seems that he got kind of rough with some of them. So, he just killed them. Oh, and he also liked little boys. Yeah, seems the Reverend would tell the little kiddies that he would give them toys if they would just... Can you see it? Here you are, a little kiddie, and some guy offers you, some toys and candy. Those stupid kids, they deserve what they got. Ain't nothing for free in this world. Hell, Sonny, you should turn your house into a museum. A museum of horror. A museum of horror.
Thank you. not real. It's not real. It's not real.
Come play with us.
Why?
I'll take you to hell with us.
Why did you come?
You killed me. Why?
Come play with us.
Why? I'll take you to hell with us.
Yes, yes, I'm here.
Thank goodness. I was so worried. Are you okay? Have you seen any more ghosts?
Yes, just leave me alone!
I imagine that's what those girls thought. We all have choices to make. And you made your choice. Raping and killing those poor little girls.
No.
Killing those other women.
They made me.
this is the last face you'll ever see.
Oh! No.
It had to be done. You were right. She did work for the government. She was gathering information on you. You had no other choice.
Why? What did they want with me?
What they want from everyone. Control. They wanted to control you. That Hunter's off the air.
No, what did they... You saying I did this? No way, man, I didn't kill anybody! I didn't kill anyone!
This is Papa Bear. Grayman, are you on the air? Grayman, are you on the air? I need to talk to you about your soul.
I'm so tired. Get out.
Police are still investigating the details, and it is unknown whether they have been able to locate the young woman's family.
It's lies. It's all lies. It's nothing but distraction and a bunch of bullshit.
Because there's no radio. There's no DVDs. And I didn't torture anyone in my living room. Our government didn't send anyone after me. It wasn't me. I'm just drunk. And kidnapping little girls. Toys. No toys.
You did this to yourself. Do it. You don't have to.
You should come with us.
Join us. It's your time. Just like it was our time.
On Elm and 36th Street.
Detective.
Hey, officer, where you going?
Looks like a suicide to me. Found a bottle of pills in the other room.
Pills? What kind of pills?
Oh, yeah, Triflu.
Triflu Oprazine?
That's right, yeah.
Ooh, man, that's some bad stuff. Those pills are used for people that are delusional, schizophrenia. You don't want to mess with that stuff.
The pill popper. Used to be a pharmacy aide before he decided he wanted to become a cop.
Oh, man, I'm much more than a pharmacy aide.
There's also an open bottle here. It looks like he's been drinking all night.
Okay. What about the exterior? Any signs of forced entry?
The door. The first uniforms on scene had to break it open.
Okay. Well, we have no signs of forced entry. Looks like a single gunshot wound to the head. There's a handgun. We know he's delusional, schizophrenia. So obviously a suicide, signal 20. Let's hope we get our 2 hours overtime and get out of here, man.
Sounds good. Let's do it.
Yeah. You do your thing with him. Interesting. Yep, trifluoperazine. It's gonna be a suicide. This bag can tag it. Thanks, Diane.
Alrighty.
Hello, does anyone copy? I think I need some help here. This is the gray man.